This week's video focuses on how to use your brain to create a life full of magic and amazing opportunities. Located in your brainstem is what is known as the reticular activating system, or RAS as I like to call it for short. RAS's role can be likened to a huge gatekeeper, which screens out most of the incoming data from the environment you live in. The reason why it does this is that at any one time you are surrounded by 2 million bits of data, but your brain only has the ability to process 147 bits at any given time. Therefore, your brain only lets in or processes information which it deems as important and relevant. Everything else is screened out. Your brain focuses and puts its attention on things it sees as important and relevant to your survival and well-being. How does your brain decide what's important and relevant? The only way you can do this is to assess the external environment against what is contained in your long-term memory. This includes all your beliefs, experiences, and conditioning. This is its default system. So if you choose to believe that something is impossible, then even if it does exist, you will not see it. You do, of course, have the power to override this RAS default system with the thinking part of your brain, known as the frontal lobes. This is as simple as choosing to put your attention and focus on what you want. Basically, what you focus on, you find. Strangely enough, quantum physics tells us the same thing. Quantum physics tells us that at any point in time, all possibilities exist, and none of you focus on one, the rest are out of existence. Let me give you a couple of examples. A common one is finding car parking spaces. Have you ever heard or experienced yourself when you're convinced you'll find a car parking spot in a busy street, you do so? As it becomes a habit of your thinking and focus, you always seem to get a parking spot where others can't. Now often people think that these parking spots just magically appear, and that they have the mind's touch. However, the truth is that the reticular activating system is working in your favor. Because you're focused and believe that money is available, your brain kicks into action, and your sight is activated to see opportunities for parking spaces. Let me give you a couple of other examples, which will demonstrate the power of your brain to find and locate things. Some years ago, when I was working for a large international company, I had the opportunity to spend a few weeks overseas working on an assignment. During this assignment, I had volunteered to take notes on what needed to happen when we all returned to our respective countries. When I arrived back in Australia, I misplaced the notes, and as I was the only one who had a copy, I was in a bit of panic. So I decided to apply the same concept I used to find parking spaces and lost keys to find these notes. Back then, I didn't know about RAS, and just thought I had this ability to conjure up lost items. So within an hour of what I termed casting it out there, I decided to walk into my training staff's office and open one of the cupboards where we stored training books and other reference material. Sitting on my bookshelves was a stack of papers about 8 inches high. I placed my hand roughly into the middle of the pile of papers and lo and behold, I found missing notes. At the time, I thought it was absolute genius. These days, I'm a little more humble and understand that it is my brain's ability to see and find things to focus on. Now you may be wondering how my brain did that. Your RAS works at an unconscious level, and remember, at any given time you're surrounded by 2 million bits of data, but they're random process at 9 million months. I believe that in my conscious level, I observe these papers being picked up my desk, along with other train notes, as to where the progress happened. When my focus was based on finding notes, my RAS kicked into action, and then you're up to find missing notes. Let me give you an example. I love to talk about missing notes and RAS in my master training. In my example, one of the assistants on program shared with me his story of how he used RAS after playing a program. He was at the beach, and he noticed that the young boy was upset at crying. He asked the young boy what was wrong, and the boy explained that he lost his swimming goggles, and his mum was very upset with him. No worries, he says to the young boy, he'll find the goggles. So he walks out and ends up in the beach, sticks his hand into the sand and seaweed, and pulls out goggles, much to the astonishment of the young boy and his mother. Now how do you do that? RAS has the capacity to see the small skin, and you push focus there. Do you think he could have found the goggles if he believed that his mother and young boy that they were lost? I conducted a life mindset training with such people, and they also had numerous stories of how they miraculously stumbled upon unbelievable sales opportunities, and as a result, they sales logical size. The unconditioned aid magic, but it's what your brain's able to do. I believe it's because the reticular activating system is the master from your brain, and as existed by food, water, as well as for survival. So the question is, how are you using your reticular activating system? Are you learning a pilot and letting your conditioned brain dictate what you see and see? Or have you taken matters into your own hands and focusing on what you want and then RAS the rest? Have you ever thought that when you focus on people's faulty weaknesses, you just see more of them and sort of beauty, strengths, and talents? Remember what you focus on you find. And what about when you brush someone with a new idea or what are you focusing on? That they probably won't like it, or that they'll absolutely love it. It is a format, you will find your attention drawn to all signs that they don't like it, and this is one way too. It is a lot, you'll be focused on the signs that they love it, and this signs that they don't. In fact, in life, there are always mixture of bad, and what you start to focus on, people will see and react to. All possibilities exist. You just need to decide, but you choose to focus on attention. Because if you start to differ between a life of amazing miracles and opportunities, or one filled with drama and impatience, what would you choose?
You may not realize it, but your brain actually processes information in two very distinct ways. Like when you look at this photo.
We do not have a box for lucky eggs. and I've been lucky. You're always going to be slightly odd, slightly different, a little weirder, person not prepared, fitting the norm. You look what I call the feature trial, because TikTok is crazy, the oohs and the ahs are like childless. But it's spite of fact, and spite of all the restriction, very much in the way to be.